Hey guys, Sean Nalawani here of BodyTransformationTruth.com. And in today's video, I want to talk a little bit about the issue of using supplement research studies versus your own personal experience when trying to decide which specific muscle building and fat burning supplements to either include or not include in your program. So over the past few years, I've put out quite a number of different bodybuilding supplement reviews where I try to give the most unbiased and most objective information that I can on different products that claim to build muscle and burn fat. And anytime one of my reviews portrays a particular supplement in a negative light, it always ends up being met with a certain amount of criticism from the people who personally use that product and who swear by its effects. Now, this is totally fine and it's to be expected, but I find that I always hear the same sort of things over and over again, like, I don't care what the studies say, I used Tribulus and it definitely worked for me, or, you know, you can't say anything about buffered creatine until you've tried it for yourself, etc., etc. Now, I obviously understand where these people are coming from. However, the truth is that there are a couple of real fundamental problems with relying solely on your own personal experience to basically gauge the effectiveness of a natural supplement that claims to help you build muscle or burn fat at a faster rate. Now, the first problem is the basic placebo effect. Now, this is much more powerful than you might think, and it comes into play big time whenever you consume a particular supplement with the positive expectation that it's going to work for you. By simply believing that the supplement is going to produce beneficial effects, either due to the marketing behind the product or, you know, firsthand reports that you've heard from other people, or just from your basic desire to have it work, it's very easy to convince yourself that your muscles look fuller or your abs look leaner or that your recovery has improved as a result of using it, even if it hasn't had any measurable impact at all. Always remember that our own perception of our bodies is directly connected with our personal beliefs, and so this can happen very easily without you even realizing it. The placebo effect is a very well-documented phenomenon, and we're all susceptible to it in one way or another. And the second problem is the very slow and very gradual nature of natural muscle growth and fat loss. Like I covered in a video last week, in the typical best case scenario, a natural trainee can probably expect to gain around half a pound of new lean muscle tissue per week. And this assumes that they're a complete beginner, that they have decent muscle building genetics, and that they're doing everything correctly in terms of training and nutrition. And for each year of consistent lifting that passes, that rate of muscle growth will decrease by about half. So let's assume that very best case scenario of half a pound of muscle per week combined with the use of a supplement that claims to increase your rate of muscle growth by 20%. And keep in mind that I'm also being very generous here because the truth is that there is no natural muscle building compound out there that is going to deliver gains anywhere close to that anyway. So this means that after 3 months of training without using the supplement, you would expect to gain around 6 pounds of new lean muscle. And by adding that supplement into your plan, you would gain an additional 1.2 pounds of muscle on top of that. The reality is that there's no way under any realistic scenario that any trainee is going to be able to accurately account for an extra 1.2 pounds of muscle over the course of 3 months, which is also equal to 1/10 of a pound of muscle per week, as a result of adding that new supplement into their program. Unless you're living in a vacuum and you're controlling every other variable of your program perfectly, from training to nutrition, to your sleeping habits, to all of your other day-to-day activities, and you're able to measure your body composition with a very high degree of accuracy, so your gains in lean muscle versus your body fat, then considering the very modest effects of even the very best, most scientifically backed supplements out there, you really have almost no way of measuring the specific long-term effects of any specific muscle building compound that you add into your program. And although fat loss does occur at a reasonably quicker pace than muscle growth does, around 1 to 2 pounds of fat loss per week, that's probably a realistic rate for most people. It would still be extremely difficult to accurately measure this for most people. So considering the 2 points that I just outlined, this is why supplementation is typically best thought of as a game of making educated guesses. And this is exactly why concrete research studies really do matter and why they should be taken into account when you're deciding which supplements to include or not include in your overall program. Obviously, many of these studies do have their own limitations, but they're still the best tool that we have in order to get a objective, concrete look at how these various supplements work across large groups of people and without our own biases getting in the way. In any case, the main point that I want to get across here is that when you do find some new supplement that you feel might be worth trying out, do your research first. Don't automatically take the attitude of, you know, I'll just try it out and see how it works for me. Instead, first take a look at the label and check out what specific ingredients are included and at what specific dosages. Don't take the marketing points seriously that the company puts out, since more often than not, they'll either be hugely overhyped or they'll just be downright false altogether. Run a Google search to see what the ingredients are, what they're supposed to do, what the proper dosages are, and what studies are available in order to support their use. Use a free resource like examine.com that combines tens of thousands of supplement studies into one place for easy use, and do some research there. Or another option is to purchase their complete supplement goals reference guide or their supplement stacks guide to make the process even easier for you. And I'll link those in the description box below if you want to check them out. If you have a particular set of people that you look to for bodybuilding advice and who you know base their recommendations on concrete science and research, then see what they have to say about it. If you want to go straight to the source and actually look up the research studies for yourself, then head over to somewhere like PubMed, and I'll link that in the description box below as well, and punch in the specific compounds that you're interested in to see if you can find any information there. When you consider how much money any given supplement can actually end up costing you when used over the long term, for example, $40 a bottle once per month, that's gonna cost you nearly $500 at the end of the year, then you owe it to yourself to make sure that you're investing that money wisely and with good reason to do so. Bottom line here, aim to be as objective as possible when making your supplement choices, since the reality is that the vast majority of them won't actually do much for you in the first place, but they will usually end up costing you quite a bit of money when you use them over the long term. So thanks a lot for watching this video lesson. I hope you found the information useful here today. If you want to get a ton of other no BS science-based muscle building and fat burning tips in order to maximize your progress in and out of the gym, make sure to head over to bodytransformationtruth.com and grab my complete body transformation blueprint system. And you can do that by clicking the icon at the top of the video or by using the link in the description box below. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. And make sure to check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest articles, tips, and other updates. Talk to you again soon.